Hello, my name is Aaron. We recently used AutoCorrect to create reusable text in Microsoft Word. That process is limited to 255 characters. Today we're going to use AutoText in Microsoft Word, which will let you reuse longer blocks of text, including images and formatting. First, we'll look at how to create AutoText blocks. Then we'll look at how to insert AutoText into your documents. Lastly, we'll look at how to delete AutoText from the gallery. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the recent single purchase versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for the web. We'll cover this topic in Word for Mac in a separate tutorial, which will be linked below upon publication. To begin creating your AutoText block, first select the content that you want to use. It's important to note that text formatting and selected objects, such as images, tables, or charts, will also be included in your new block. Next, select the Insert tab. From there, select Quick Parts, followed by AutoText in the drop-down menu. And then select Save Selection to AutoText Gallery from the submenu. When the Create New Building Block dialog box appears, enter a unique name into the text box. In the Category menu, the default option General will be appropriate for most users. However, you can select Create New Category if you'll be using several different types of AutoText blocks that will need to be organized by category. You also have the option to add a short description. The default option Normal in the Save In menu will be the best option for most users. You can now select an insertion method from the Options menu. Insert Content Only inserts the AutoText where you place your cursor in the document. Even though it says Content Only, any images or formatting that you selected will still be included. This will likely be the best choice because you will have additional options when inserting the AutoText blocks, which we'll see in the next section. However, you can also insert the AutoText in its own paragraph or page. Lastly, select the OK button. Your AutoText block should now be available to use in future documents. To insert an AutoText block, place your cursor in the document where you want to make the insertion. Then select the Insert tab, followed by Quick Parts and AutoText. Select the block in the submenu to insert it into your document where you placed your cursor, or right-click the block and then select an insertion point from the shortcut menu. For example, you can insert it into the header, footer, beginning of the section, beginning of the document, or end of the document. Today I'm going to choose End of Document. After making your choice, the AutoText should be inserted into your document. Now we're going to look at how to delete an AutoText block from the gallery. It's important to note that deleting a block from the AutoText gallery doesn't delete occurrences of that text previously inserted into your documents. To begin, select the Insert tab, and then select Quick Parts. From there, select Building Blocks Organizer. When the Building Blocks Organizer dialog box appears, locate the AutoText block that you want to delete, followed by the Delete button. And then select the Yes button in the dialog box asking if you're sure you want to make the deletion. Finally, select the Close button. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at aaronwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to create WordArt in Microsoft Word for PC and Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.